chapter 29. In this problem, there is a mass with a charge Q, and this is an electric field E which is suddenly switched on. So this sudden word has to be read very carefully in all questions. What happens when this is done? Before I do that, let me explain some basics. Now take a spring and let there be a mass M. Spring constant is K, and you hold this mass via support, and now you gradually allow it to come down, and allow it to come down till such time it can come down by the extension in the spring, which is delta equilibrium, and it is now not going further down, so you remove the support. What are the forces which are acting here? K delta equilibrium would be equal to mg. So delta equilibrium position is always this. But what happens when this is released suddenly? When this is released suddenly, the situation is different. So please read the question very carefully when such thing is mentioned, and when you release it suddenly, suppose it falls through this. There you have to apply the energy equation. This is the delta maximum. It falls down. What is the fall in potential energy? Is mg delta maximum. And what is the gain in potential energy of the spring? Is half m delta maximum square. At the extreme position, its velocity is zero, so we have not taken the kinetic energy. Now what is the delta maximum? Is equal to half k, sorry, k delta square. It will be equal to delta maximum equal to twice mg upon k. This is the value of delta maximum at this position. Now see what are the forces acting. Force mg downwards, and what is the upward force? Is k delta maximum. K delta maximum will be equal to twice mg. So there is a net force acting upwards, so spring will start coming upwards, and it is being acted by net force upwards till such time it reaches a position where mg is equal to k delta equilibrium. At this position, there is no force, net force acting on it, because k equilibrium is equal to mg. But it will still keep on moving because it is having maximum velocity at this point. Now this kinetic energy which it has gained by this movement is converted into the potential energy of the body. So what is this amplitude of simple harmonic motion in this case? It will be the delta equilibrium minus delta maximum. So delta maximum minus delta equilibrium. So it will be twice mg upon k minus mg upon k. It will be mg upon k. So this is how we should find out the amplitude of the simple harmonic motion when the body is released suddenly. Or the, now let us take this case here. The electric field is suddenly switched on, so the force will be EQ acting on it, and this force will do some work, and there will be extension, let us call it delta maximum, due to this work done, and accordingly energy will be stored in the spring, will be half k delta maximum square is equal to EQ is the force due to electric field, delta maximum. So delta maximum is equal to twice EQ upon M. this is the maximum extension. Now see what are the forces acting here. Force acting towards right is EQ, and this is towards this direction, and force of spring will be K delta maximum will be K, this is actually K delta maximum, K delta maximum, which is equal to twice EQ. So see, the force, net force, is acting backwards. So after having gone delta maximum, it will keep coming, and net force will keep on acting it. What is the point at which net force is equal to zero? It will be when EQ is equal to K delta, let us call equilibrium. So delta equilibrium is equal to EQ upon K. At this point, the net force acting on the body is zero, but it has acquired velocity because of this energy which is released by the spring, energy which is being there in the body when it starts moving here. So because of this velocity, it reaches at the other extreme point, and this keeps on happening. Now what is the amplitude of the simple harmonic motion? Amplitude of simple harmonic motion would be delta maximum minus delta equilibrium will be twice EQ upon M minus EQ upon M is equal to EQ upon M. Let me also show that this motion is simple harmonic motion. That it's a simple harmonic motion. Let me redraw it, and let me just remove this part. This is the initial position. This is the extreme position to which it had gone after switching on of the electric field. This is delta maximum. Delta maximum. And we have found delta equilibrium, which was equal to EQ upon K. This is the equilibrium position, means where no net force was acting on it, the forces was just balancing. And now let us see a displacement x from this position. We are measuring x from this position, this mean position. So mx double dot would be equal to, what are the forces acting on the at this position? What is the force due to spring? Will be minus K x plus delta equilibrium, because the extensions of spring at this point is, this is x and this is delta equilibrium. You have to take the total extension of the spring. So this is the force which is opposing it, and what is the force which is helping the motion is equal to is plus EQ. So we get minus KX minus K delta equilibrium plus EQ. And what is this? K delta equilibrium is equal to EQ, so these two get cancelled. So MX double dot would be equal to minus KX, which is nothing but the equation of simple harmonic motion. So in this case, omega would be equal to root K upon M. So this is the frequency of the simple harmonic motion, and amplitude we have already found out would be delta maximum minus delta equilibrium, which is EQ upon K. So that solves the problem. Thank you.